for the first time in 21 series, there'll be a sixth guest chair on Dragon's Den. In the seat, Gary Neville.
Very good. He'll have to use some of his own money then, won't he? Won't have Peter Lim next to him, will he?
Gary Neville will be the sixth guest in the chair on Dragon's Den. Who's that appears in that? Where's Theo?
Theo doesn't do it anymore.
Theo Pepitas.
He doesn't do it anymore. An old opera of mine, Peter Jones, does it. So that's all I know that's on it. Doesn't Deborah Meaden still do it? I think Deborah does it. I've known Deborah for years. 21 years. Has that been going 21 years, that show?
21 series.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I turned it down for a series.
You turned it down for a series. Okay.
Silly me.
So were you not on the original Dragon's Den?
No. I went and did an ITV show with Duncan Bannatyne, who was on Dragon's Den. Duncan Bannatyne, Jeffrey Archer, the late Jacqueline Gold, Kanya King. We did a show on ITV.
Yes.
But I didn't fancy Dragon's Den. But it's a good show. I'm not so sure. I think it's run its course now. And it will definitely run its course if it's got the old champagne socialist in there.
Out of interest, why did you not fancy Dragon's Den?
I don't know. My PR guy at the time said, well, what do I need to do that for? And why would I be giving the BBC some of my money to invest in things that I don't want to invest in? Thank you very much. I've got enough bleeding problems at a football club.
Back in the, on the subject of football, incidentally, Alan Pardew is going to be joining us at 12:30 here in studio for the final half hour today. UEFA holding a two-day meeting this week to discuss rule changes over multi-club ownership in football. What we do know, Simon, is that current regulations allow owners to buy more than one football club, provided they don't play in the same competition as one another, with the lower-ranked side disqualified in the instance of that happening. Where do we stand in this, Simon? The rise of multi-club ownership, should the rules be tightened or relaxed?
I think it should be tightened, and I've always felt it should be tightened, because it's one thing buying football clubs in different hemispheres where you're not likely to come into conflict with one another on a sporting integrity basis is another thing where you, and this is not because of Man City, because Chelsea are doing it and other people will do it. It is because I've always felt there was a conflict of interest there. And I think sometimes football doesn't look at things through the right prism. It didn't look at the agents properly years and years ago when the more money came into football, rather than regulate agents more tightly, they deregulated and allowed the agents to get themselves in a position they think they could do as they wanted.
Yeah.
And you've now got the situation where you've got multi-club ownership deals, and I understand the benefits of it, and again I advocate for the idea. It's one thing putting aside having an ownership in a side in America or in Brazil or in other parts of the world. But when you've got them in the same space, in the same competitions, and eventually they may land playing one another, you put yourself in a question where the sporting integrity becomes a debate, and I don't see why the necessity of it is.
Oh, that's a good point. I mean, that very much could happen for Brighton in the person of Tony Bloom, the owner, because Brighton qualified for the Europa League. The Belgian Pro League side, Royal Union Saint-Gilloise, could very well do the same, but both are owned by Tony.
I know, yeah.
So in the instance of the two of them meeting each other, obviously, a problem would arise in the horizon.
Well, it'd be interesting. Yeah, I mean, it'll be interesting. Some would say that. Well, why would that be the case? Because ultimately, you've got two competitive sides playing in a league. But you've got the very notion and width of anything that compromises the integrity of the sport can bring it into a space that you don't want it to be in. And so, how UEFA will come around this and look at the fact that this structure already exists. So they're going to suggest that then the current owners of various football clubs are now going to have to dispose of these assets and ultimately all that goes with that, or they're going to reduce their shareholding in them to be less of a majority and more of a minority shareholder. And, you know, they've created a problem for themselves because they have allowed it to be... There was a rule, and I still believe that rule exists about the ownership models inside leagues or competitions that may collide at some point, but they've allowed it to be bent and they've allowed it to be adapted and they've allowed themselves to be pushed around a little bit because huge money's coming and saying, well, I want to build a brand and I want to build a whole raft of football clubs underneath it. So now they've created a problem and now they're going to try and look for the fix of it.
What? Correct me if I'm wrong, Simon. I cannot for the life of me see what the problem would be for Bloom with the two clubs, though. Because there is an obvious conflict of interest, of course. The same guy owns the two clubs. And then what? They play each other.
Yeah.
So what?
Well,
the inference is where?
If there was a preference, if someone were able to concoct a theory that there was a preference for one club to progress over the other club, and subsequently the club that was not that motivated in the equation by the ownership model's motivation played a weakened side, or challenge the sporting integrity of the situation, it becomes about the notion that there is too much influence in the destiny of a sporting fabric by the motivations of an ownership model that may have different views about sporting integrity because two teams are playing. It's like, I remember years and years ago, this is a poor example, but it's an example of me making a film with Ray Winston, and then the BBC went to sell it, right? And when they sold it, they packaged it with a whole load of other films at MIPCOM, and because there was more financial cost implications of the money that I required from the film, they allocated a certain amount to my film and a certain amount to other people's films, and so that I got less money out of the equation because that was the equation they wanted to achieve.
I see.
In this instance, if you've got an ownership model that thinks there's more benefit in Brighton advancing in a European tournament than the Belgium team, and subsequently lean on the team, on the coach, to potentially field a weakened side, what does that say?
Right.
So why have that in the equation?
For sure.
I mean, it's a reach and it's a stretch.